Cerebral satire contains strong language and thoughts that may offend. If you are easily offended, don't fucking bother listening.
Friday, therefore it's Cerebral Satire Day. Welcome to Cerebral Satire, everybody. I got my buddies Ant and Wayne here. What up, fellas?
I'm good.
How you doing?
Oh shit, it's gonna be one of those episodes.
No, I was actually, for once, because I've been told I always jump in first and I don't let Wayne go.
Yeah.
So I thought I'd let Wayne go and then I'll get that bollocks.
I was expecting you to cut me off in mid-flow. So.
Well, I didn't. I was being a gentleman for once. But do you know what, mate? From now on, you can go fuck yourself. Just cut you off.
Oh, the love.
Hello, mate. How you doing?
The love I can feel. What have you guys been up to this week, man? Wayne, what you been up to? I'm going to ask you first. So I always ask Ant first.
I'm not ready. Why are you lot throwing this stuff on me? The pressure.
Now he's not ready. Ant, what have you been up to?
Not a lot, really. Been working. Have I done anything, Amy? I ain't done fuck all, have I? Been working. Just the normal 9-to-5 shit this week. Nothing since I ain't had a drink, like I usually don't until Cerebral Saturday night. So I'm currently drinking a nice red wine. Been having dreams.
What kind of
nice dreams? I've been dreaming about
Xbox Ones?
Yeah.
Is that a slight hint to Amy to buy you an Xbox?
Yeah, so I've been dreaming about Xboxes. It is a little bit of a hint, I suppose.
You suppose? You and I talk about Batman all the time, about that video game, Batman Arkham Asylum. You haven't even played the last one yet. I fucking beat it. I beat the whole thing.
I know. That's the whole thing. Like, I don't know how much time I'll be able to get to play it. So I reckon I might wait till like New Year, like the sales, and see what comes up then.
I want him to get one so I can have one more friend.
There's more sales during Christmas than there is during New Year's.
Not over here. Yeah, because you have like Black Friday and all that not stuff as well, didn't you? We don't really do that
Black much. Friday kicked off in the last 2 years, but Walmart have already turned around and said that they're not doing it this year because it turned too violent.
You guys can't handle shit.
No, so that's already... So that boomed for about 2 years and they're already started
that's
fading
it, they're
away.
Done. Yeah. Well,
it's too Americanized for us.
It's very Americanized, dude. It's super
That's why we
Americanized.
Like Valentine's Day and all the other shit that you have.
We're opening up at 5 p.m. on Thanksgiving.
That's crazy. You can't even get Thanksgiving out the way.
Nope. Not anymore. No Thanksgiving. No more. No such thing as thanks. So
that's fucking savage. Yeah. That is.
And we already like I was talking to my boss. We had a meeting about Black Friday. My boss. She said we ruined it, and she's right. We ruined it. We can't go back now. We've made too much
that's
money.
It. You've done it. Made a rough your own backs.
That's it. All the retailers are like that now. They all open at like 6, 7, 5, 2. Eventually, we're just not going to close. It'll just be a normal shopping
day. Do they do Black Friday across like every store almost?
Yeah, every store.
So if Wayne could, because you work at a reputable children's store, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
I'm not going to say the name. It's got me in trouble before.
Please don't. I don't want to edit this much out.
That'll be awesome.
I got to fix enough stuff already at work. I don't want to.
But if like, do you reckon? Like maybe porn shops could do a thing.
It's weird. What? Who does?
Think about Wayne buying himself a thingy sleeve.
That's Cyber Monday.
Flashlight.
That's Cyber Monday.
That wouldn't be secondhand, would it?
No.
What? Used by fucking Tyrone.
Why would you even bring that up? What?
No, Wayne. Wayne, do you want my flashlight?
Do you want my slightly used flashlight? It's got a ginormous hole in the middle of it. It looks more like a donut than it does pussy.
Don't worry. I'll get my cock out so you can see how big it is compared to yours.
Do you reckon that'd be like with the Amazon used grade? That'd be like new.
So
only slight stain.
One previous owner, 12-inch black.
one previous jizz bomb. No, they do Cyber Monday. So we have Black Friday now, which is actually Black Thursday and Friday and Saturday. So it just goes on all week. And then they have Cyber Monday, which is where all the online dealers. So if you want a Fleshlight, Wayne, I would buy it on.
He needs to buy one because Claire's out again, isn't she, Wayne?
Dude, you need.
Where's Claire, Wayne?
She's gone down to Spoons.
What's Spoons?
Spoons is a national brand, so that they owe us 150 quid now.
It's like a chili. It's like
Weatherspoons. It's a chain pub slash restaurant.
So it's like it's like a Chili's or an app.
It's think of a bar.
It sells
What's
cheap
the famous
beer.
Bar?
Mm-hmm. It sells cheap beer.
A famous bar.
Like a chain bar.
Yeah, like Chili's or app, and they have food and stuff.
But it's really shit food. Microwave.
Yeah, it's
a la ping.
Yeah, yeah. It's like
apparently
it's like
there's
an
no oven in that kitchen in the Spoon.
Yeah,
I can't hope microwave. That rumor.
You know,
is
I can't. True. I can't wait till you guys come over here. I'm gonna feed you guys all classic. Take you guys to all the shittiest restaurants ever.
So say, I might
ever.
As well just go down to Spoons and save some money.
Go down to Spoons. So who's she down the Spoons with, Wayne?
Tesco lot again. I think a lesbian.
The three women.
I think that there's the older one, the lesbian one, and
so
they're out again.
What
they're
Wayne? Why don't you go out with them?
They're not my friends.
They're not. They weren't your friends while you worked at Tesco.
I'd go just to keep an
Everyone
eye on
hated
what she's
me.
Getting up to, mate.
Dude, I would. Tell my
she's
wife.
Blatantly licking minge under the tables in the Spoons.
Mate, I'd rather lick the tables than the food.
So what you? So you weren't friends with these people before?
No.
So these are recent.
Bakers didn't get on with other people.
Wayne, I'm just going out for fish and chips.
Okay, bye. Bring me back
what
a curry.
What sort of fish?
Bring me back a curry, please.
Leg fish.
Clam.
Clam. Classic clam. So bakers don't get on with anybody else in the whole.
No, we're like lepers.
You guys are more like assholes.
No.
I bet the Tesco bunch are a wild bunch.
Oh, I bet they're crazy.
They're crazy. The shenanigans.
Wild and crazy guys.
They're assholes.
Wayne, did you? Was there like a lot of sleeping together?
What are their names?
At Tesco's, did people cheat on each other? Did they date each other?
It was like a big soap opera.
Almost every retake.
What are their names? Wayne, so we can pick nicknames for these people.
First names.
Yeah, just first names.
I'm going to announce. I don't know her. I don't know. Let's have a look.
You don't know any of her friends' names?
Oh.
You've never met
You're
them.
A wanker. You have never even speak about like conversation about. Oh, I'm going out with Jess or something.
Claire talks.
Mate, you are such a wanker.
Asshole. Oh my god.
Fucking hell. You are the catch of the day.
And name two of Amy's friends.
Charlotte and Pickle.
Boom. Done. Pickle.
Same person. That's the same person. You put me on the spot. Charlotte Pickle, Tweaky, Uli.
Tweaky.
Fluffy.
What the
Susie,
fuck?
Susie.
Are you saying real names?
I think he's mugging you
I
off.
Think he's
no,
making them up.
Amy's sat right here. Are they all real names?
All is Amy's only friends.
Wait,
like dogs.
Wait. Tweaky's real name. That's a real name. Fluffy's a real name.
Her real name is Jane.
Oh, okay. See? But it's like,
and that's massive information there because she never uses that.
Are these like names they named each other in college?
Yeah, I think it's the uni names
lame.
Or some shit.
Fucking lame shit.
There we go, Megan.
he had to look it up on his Facebook.
Are you face raping people now?
He's Facebook stalking.
He would know.
Which one's Megan? What's she look like? Is she the lesbian?
Yeah. I was about to say the lesbian. They're all lesbians.
How about Meg doesn't like to peg?
Surely if she's a lesbian, she would.
No, pegging is when you fuck a guy,
pegging's
dude,
isn't it?
I thought, what is when the women are scissoring?
That's a scissoring?
It's called scissoring.
Oh,
no,
enough.
I suppose you can peg a girl, I suppose, up the arse, can't
no,
you?
Yeah, like
no.
wouldn't, oh.
No, then it wouldn't be. It wouldn't
strap on up an arse.
Yeah, no, then that's just regular lesbian sex.
Yeah, so make the peg.
Oh, shit.
With a wonky leg.
What more names? Come on. We're giving these people nicknames.
Anything else?
Because they're a crazy Tesco bun.
Wild and crazy guys.
I've got to go back into Facebook now, have I?
Oh, fuck that. Don't.
All right.
Claire with a mouth with pubic hair.
I was. What up?
But yeah, anyway.
Yeah, you're not up to anything. Wayne, what have you been up to?
Drove a little bit.
Well, that's your job, hopefully.
Yep.
That's it.
Wayne, can I just quickly ask, have you been to King's Kitchen this week?
That's not the one that you put on GroupMe.
Well, it's the closest one I could find. It's Bury St. Edmunds and it's King's Kitchen.
Yeah, but it's not. Apparently there's an app called Stow Grub and he's on that.
Oh, I cannot believe that's even an app.
You're not answering the question. Have you been there this week?
Yeah.
How many times?
Just once, actually.
What did you have? Sausage roll.
No, I didn't have sausage roll.
Bacon roll?
I get that from Burger. The station.
Burger.
No. Sausage and bacon butty.
Sausage. Sausage and what?
Bacon.
So all he has to do is add the bacon to the roll
like
and it's done, yeah.
So I phoned him up and I told him, can you get it ready for 11:40? I got there. He got quite pissed off. I was like, well, did you try ringing me?
Hey, Wayne, I told you.
And he goes, where were you? It was an hour ago. I went, no, I was in Bury then. That's why I put a phone order in.
Hey, Wayne, you should be.
So then he microwaved it and then knocked 50p off.
Wayne, you cannot piss off the guy who's going to be feeding you. It's 200.
I didn't do anything wrong. He says if you're going to be in a rush, give him a phone call. So I fucking phoned him. And I can't help it if he can't fucking clear his ears out.
Leave it to Wayne to piss off the one guy that's willing to feed him food.
Yeah, and the one guy who Wayne puts on a pedestal over his own wife.
I know. He always does this, too. He meets people, he becomes best friends with them, and then he gets miscommunicated, and then he gets pissed off at them.
Does it with us all the time.
He
so.
Does 11:40 sound like 10:40?
All the time.
Did the clock? Was it when the clocks went back?
Maybe he got a fucking clock in his little hut. I don't know.
Hey, Wayne, I don't know. It's the day. It's the time.
He's not Italian.
He is.
That's what I was thinking too. I was like, is he Italian? What else, Wayne? What else?
Foreign of some kind.
You guys are gonna. You guys are gonna hook up this week.
Well, no, it'd be next. Yeah.
This weekend. Yeah.
Yeah. This weekend.
Don't break the wall.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
I was trying not to break the wall.
Last weekend. You guys are going to meet up last weekend.
No, this weekend.
Oh, my God.
Fucking hell. He's destroyed. We were trying not to break the wall, and he just run through it like a fucking barbarian.
American. Thank you.
Then built it again, and then smashed it again.
Thank you.
Well, so you guys are
You guys are getting together to watch Survivor Series?
Yeah, we're going to go up. Wayne's going to take me out to...
Spoons.
Stew.
Should we go down King's Kitchen as well?
Yes. And then I can take some pictures and we can put it up on the website me at King's Kitchen. And I want pictures of me and Claire on the pole.
Oh.
We're going to do a picture fest next Sunday.
Finally, something on the internet I could beat off to. Finally. I've been looking for something.
What, me and a pole?
you and Claire on a pole. Finally. Yeah, I've been looking for that picture forever.
Like a national pole.
A national pole?
Yeah, like Polish man.
He's fucking retarded.
What pole?
I bet there's enough of them in
Stowmarket. Wait, have you never been to Spoons where you're with your wife?
Spoons. Weatherspoons.
Spoons.
There's no pole dancing at the Spoons.
There is pole. I've seen the pole.
Where is Claire pole dancing?
How do you know what's at the fucking Spoons?
It's on her Facebook.
We've seen pictures.
Yes.
You keep saying that Claire keeps going to the Spoons.
Where are
and
these
we
fucking
see pictures
poles?
Online of Claire on a pole. Me and him put two and two together.
Yeah.
You're getting fired.
What?
There's no pole at the Spoons.
Where is Claire on the pole?
Where's this pole?
Her day job, man. Her day job.
If you go on your own wife's Facebook, you'll see your missus on a pole.
Yeah, she's...
Oh my God,
she's,
I had some really bad hair then.
She's got some gay bloke on the other side of her.
He says he's gay.
Yeah, he probably is.
Oh, go on, have a little look at your missus' face. She's on a pole dancing, mate.
There's no right, pole.
Let me tell you about my week while he's looking.
Yeah.
There's no pole.
So...
There is... Go on her Facebook now. She's on a pole.
She is on a pole. She's on a pole. She's in her little devil outfit on a pole.
Devil outfit on a pole.
Yeah.
There's no fucking devil outfit.
Go fucking out.
Has she
you talk about
me?
Your week. You fucking look on Facebook and you talk about your week.
All right. So I started out Sunday traveling 2 hours here and then walked the store, came back to the hotel, slept, got up, did 11 hours at the store, and then I drove... Tuesday I drove 2 hours back to my place and then a half an hour to school and then I went to school and then I drove half an hour back home, and then I drove 2 hours to another store to go to a meeting, and then I drove 3 hours back here on Wednesday, and then I've been here ever since, and then my boss walked yesterday and told me, that's just working.
And you have been doing it all week as well, haven't you?
Yeah, all week, every single day.
Been a busy boy. Yep. Seems that...
Not to mention, school on top of that. I still got to do paper. But it is what it is, and I'm glad I get to talk to you guys, honestly, for a day, because I talked to my parents for like a half.
It's like me the other week.
Yeah, exactly. I was thinking this same thing, too. I was like, oh, man, I think his aunt. Talk to
Wayne, I've just posted you a picture of your wife on a pole in GroupMe. You go into GroupMe, mate.
Exist.
Go into GroupMe. And
now,
Gowen,
Christ's sake, let me get my dick out.
Fuck?
Who's that monging bloke?
I told you.
Oh, there's a new bloke on the scene. Wayne don't know this bloke.
I told you, Wayne. I told you this during Halloween. The Halloween show. If you go back and listen to the Halloween show.
Where the fuck is this picture? She got like me like deselected on Facebook or something.
Possibly, Wayne. Maybe hiding it from you. Even Amy said she's seen that picture.
That dude looks gay as the day's long.
I don't know.
You don't think so?
Looks like he's about to fucking dive in for a motorboat.
There's a picture later of the same fella with Claire, and it looks like he's giving her, licking her out like they're doing it as a laugh, but I don't reckon.
You are so fucking stupid.
I'm right. I'll get that picture as well, shall I?
Really? I haven't seen that one. Show me that one.
Where are these pictures?
Did you put on her Facebook page?
They're not on the fucking Facebook.
She got you locked out, brother.
Right, here we go. Ready?
Are you putting on GroupMe?
It looks like she is giving him a blowjob. Here we go. Hang on. It's loading up on GroupMe now, Wayne. 3, 2, 1.
Well, it looks like...
There you go. He looks very happy on his little face.
Well, it looks like we're adding some pictures to the website this week, guys.
See, Mrs. is sucking off a boat.
Wayne, who's that cunt right there?
Who is
that?
I don't even know who that is.
You don't know who that loser is right there?
Why is he putting his thumb up?
Because he's getting a blowy off. Your missus is sucking off men in Stowmarket while you're in here talking to us.
My gosh, where are these fucking pictures?
On her Facebook page. It's not like she's hiding it. All you have to do is pay attention to your wife.
Yeah. In one ear, out the next, while she's putting cocks in her mouth.
She was talking at some point yesterday, Aunt. She was talking at some point. I don't know what she was saying. She probably was telling him, oh, so I blew Gary yesterday.
Wayne, just to let you know that I've sucked off 3 guys in spoons and done a pole dance.
Right.
Oh, yeah. What did she just look into?
Thank you, Claire. Make
if
me dinner.
You listened.
Look, there's another. I found it now. There's another fucking one.
Yeah, oh, no. We've created some tension.
Oh, shit.
That's fucking. What was Excel? I didn't even know that fucking club was still open.
Wow.
Right, should we move on?
Yeah, I guess we're going to move on.
Let's get this show started.
All right, here we go, guys. Let's go.
Touching my cock.
The driver on the bus say sit.
Wank, wank, wank.
Oh, shit.
So, Ant, why are we talking about wheels on the bus?
Because we have got our very own bus driver here.
We do.
And I saw this story, which is in the Evening Standard. Not often do I plug the source. And you can hear my baby in the background. I apologize.
It's all good. Don't apologize.
This is from the Evening Standard. And this is the London bus driver who has been suspended after being filmed pleasuring himself on the top deck.
Let me be honest, did you think this was Wayne, didn't you?
I did. I even posted it on Facebook saying, Wayne, what the fuck have you been doing?
I think he's more looking like he's curling one off.
Is there an actual picture of him?
There's a video.
There's an actual video of it.
Really?
Yeah, there's an actual video of it. You can see online. It's on YouTube.
About 1:20.
1:20, is it? Okay, let me read the story and then we'll go on how you can... Oh, my God. Sorry about this, guys.
It's fine. You have a baby. It's fine. Fuck all them.
So a London bus driver has been suspended after he was filmed appearing to engage in a lewd act with his trousers down on the top deck of a bus. Fucking hell. Should we start the story again?
You want to
No, we'll carry on. Fuck it, we'll do it live.
All right, do it live.
Footage emerges of a middle-aged driver appearing to pleasure himself next to a window on an upper deck while leaning over on one of the chairs. The vulgar scene was visible from the street and was filmed by someone outside the route of the 123 bus in Wood Green, North London. It was posted on YouTube under the heading... Sorry?
He's leaning over and jerking it like if he was in the shower. Yeah.
So if you do want to see it, guys, it was posted on YouTube under the heading London Bus Driver Jerking Off on Service.
So just describe the video, really, and the video will come out.
Yeah, just put London Bus Driver Jerking Off. The man appears to have dropped his trousers and underwear, but he keeps his T-shirt on throughout the act. It lasts about 90 seconds before he stops doing what he's doing and pulls his trousers up. The filmmaker cuts away for a few seconds before capturing a clear shot of the bus driver's face after he'd gone downstairs. The man appears to be middle-aged, white, and with dark hair. It doesn't say if he was short on, but he can be seen closing the bus doors, but it's not known if they were left open during the incident. Yeah, Wayne, what have you been doing, mate?
Not me. I think that still looked like he's curling one out. That's not... one aisle.
Have you got to just be a wanker to be a bus driver? Is that the whole thing?
You got to be a little bit dirty to be.
I know. There's a bloke suspended and that from First the other just before I come on because that was still the talk of the company.
Oh, what? Sorry?
A driver from First got suspended because he was caught shagging a colleague on the bus.
You can see his ass.
What? Two men?
I don't know. Didn't go into that.
Dude, he is a woman. Seriously, he is blatantly fucking beating that dick, man. Like a 2-year-old at a urinal with their pants all the way down.
Why wouldn't you do it sitting down?
I have no idea. Why wouldn't you do it laying down so no one can see you?
Why wouldn't you do it at home?
Wayne, he's got a...
They're long old days.
Oh, he totally splooged.
They're long old days. That's the excuse, is
it? Dude, he totally just splooged on that seat. All over that seat.
What did you just say? Splooged.
Yeah. Oh my god. Wayne, he does.
I've never heard that word.
Wayne, I would say he looks like you, except for he's taller than you.
Oh. Is it your dad?
He's got a big old belt. He looks like he's fucking.
Didn't your dad take a bus driving job at your place, Wayne?
No, he's only a veto driver.
A veto? What's that mean?
Basically, they're 9-person things you can drive on a car license.
So your dad's never wanked on a bus?
No. Well, he might have, but he not while he was playing.
I'd like to meet your dad. Tell me a bit more about your dad.
No, he was the driver.
Tell me about your dad.
He touched
bloke. Lives.
Come on. He must have some funny stories about your dad.
He's
come on.
He's lived in Stow Upland all his life.
He's lived in Stow Upland all his life. How did he meet your mum?
She lived in Stow Upland.
Did they
met at the retreat, which is the pub in Stow Upland.
Oh, is that pub still there?
Yeah.
What's it now called? Is it still the same pub?
The Retreat.
It is still The Retreat. Wow. It's amazing. Have they ever travelled?
No.
No.
No, neither of them got a passport.
Your dad's... You are a carbon copy of your old man, aren't you?
No, he's a lot taller than me.
Is he? how tall is he?
He's... I think he's like 6 foot. My mum's 4'10". So my brother... My brother took after my dad... And I took after my mum.
Your brother's 6 foot?
Near enough, yeah. If not a little bit taller.
You
and
look like
me.
You look like the retarded adopted child.
No, yeah, I look like
Downs.
My mother.
He looks like... Does your mum look like she's got Downs?
No. Because they've got round noses and my mum's got quite a pointy one.
Is that the only difference between someone with Down syndrome and your mum? Their nose is different.
I can't imagine. Wayne, when you go to the grocery store, can you reach the top shelf?
With a kickstool, yeah.
What's your dad's mum and dad's names? Are you not gonna say that?
Actually, no, because I know what you done with DV's mum. So.
Smart man.
Judy still loves me. Don't give it all that, because Judy still texts me wanting my penis.
Does she?
Yes, she does.
I find that
still in contact with each other.
Yeah,
and your nan, she still texts me. Can't remember her name.
I thought we were talking about bus drivers.
We are talking about bus drivers. I wanted to get on talking about his dad, but
why do you want to talk about his dad?
Because I thought his dad was a bus driver as well.
No. He was a postman for like 30-40 years.
Oh, he liked his delivery.
Hey, did he old school style walk the post like?
Well, he had a van. He weren't going to fucking walk to Wetherham set, was he?
I don't know.
It's not old school. That's new school now over here, mate. People, that's what they still do.
Your your mail people still walk?
Yeah.
Yes, they do.
He'll take the van to the village he's delivering to and pretty much then walk it.
That's very
quaint.
Why is
that weird?
It's very quaint. What we call that quaint.
Quaint? Why is that quaint?
Do you have fucking drones deliver your postal
yeah,
shit?
Yeah, they've got some, Amazon drones some, come around now.
Some we do, yeah. We have
do you know what, Wayne, when they deliver your post, little flag, American flags pop out with fireworks and it goes, woo, woo! You got mail.
Woo, woo, USA, USA.
We did something right.
Fuck yeah. Comes with free burger.
Free burger chips
oh my God.
And bullets.
I wish it could have free burger. I'd order mail all the time. No, I don't know. I mean, I'm sure they walk in, like, maybe New York.
Do they have disabled buggies that they ride around in?
right in there. Disabled buggies for what?
Ride round to do the post.
No.
What?
Why? No. They have a mail car.
They could be like Xavier out of X-Men.
Floating around on his fucking...
Because he's British.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you. He's British. They're both British, Magneto and...
I know.
Anything else you want to say about the wanking bus driver?
Well, I just think Wayne is a master baker. It should be his name still. Or... Wayne is a bus wanker. It's got to be one of the two.
I kind of enjoy bus wanker.
You don't know what it's from.
Doesn't matter what it's from, does it?
It's
a bus wanker. Bus wanker.
Funny when you know what it's from.
What's it from?
Inbetweeners.
Is that something from the Inbetweeners, Ant?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a shitty British sitcom. But
yeah, I have it on my net.
Don't watch the American version.
No, it's the British version.
Oh, good.
I watched Peep Show this week. It's returned, which is fantastic.
Last series.
Was it good?
Last series. It's a little bit like Curb Your Enthusiasm, I'd say.
Oh, okay.
But the British version. It's very, very good. Very good.
No, you don't seem as...
No, because Curb Your Enthusiasm is just utter genius.
Yeah, you're...
Oh, I'm a huge Curb Your Enthusiasm fan. Absolutely massive Larry David fan. It's just genius. But Peep Show is on the same level, but it's the British version, pretty much.
I don't have my DVR, man. I caught Arrow and Supernatural because I was home.
What series is Arrow on now? Four?
Yeah, actually. Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Do you know, what did I watch the other day? Flash.
It's...
I thought it was really shit.
Really? What? But you didn't start out from the beginning.
No, I just watched a random episode and I
fair.
Just thought this is
come on.
Over the top
come
American
that's
drama
not,
cheese.
That's not fair. You need to watch from the beginning.
I've watched an episode and I'm saying from my opinion from the one episode I have watched is that it was shit. But I'll tell you what is that I watched once
what?
And I'm not going to return to it. Supergirl.
Yeah, me neither.
See,
it's
I
not,
gave that
it's
one
not,
episode.
It's not for us.
And that's no.
It's not for us. It's not for us. It's for the female audience.
It's for the female audience.
Yeah.
I don't think that's fair.
Why?
Because they're probably going for like the teen girl sort of
that's exactly
audience.
What they're, that's exactly what.
But it's still shit. I think that's a slur on teen girl audiences.
There is, I have heard a couple people talk about it, and I agree with some and disagree with others, and I watched it with my buddy Jamie went on. And I thought it was well done. I just did not care for the characters.
Throw money at it. It's just shit. It's a load of old bollocks.
Yeah, I just didn't like it. I just didn't like it. It just wasn't for me. And that's fine. Not everything has to be. Not every superhero has to be. I mean, it's a superhero show, so it's fine. Let it be.
I felt similar about The Flash.
If you watch The Flash from the beginning, it's a lot like... It's the same standard format of like The Arrow and Smallville and things like that. You have to watch from the beginning to get to know those characters.
See, Smallville I liked.
Yeah, well, once you watch...
I'm a fan of Smallville.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's the same format. So once you watch in the beginning, you slowly know those characters and they start meaning things
to
you.
You have to watch loads then, don't you? You can't drift in and out.
It's only one season.
Yeah, but like if I want to start Arrow, I've got, I'm four series behind.
Yeah. Well, three.
It comes a slog.
Two.
And that's
behind.
Why I put off Game of Thrones for like 3 years.
I don't know. You know
because
that now.
Because I did make a mistake on it. I don't know if I made a mistake on it because I come into series four and I was just like, this is fucking, like everything was still fresh, you know?
Yeah.
Because every new series, you're like, I can't remember her name. What's her name?
And especially with Game of Thrones, you can never remember any characters' names.
Exactly. So, like, I came in watching three series in a block, and then fourth series started. I was like, oh, okay, cool. Now can go sort of straight away. So yeah.
You know they're not on their normal.
But yeah, the reason I put it off was because it was like, I have to watch it from the start. Well, I was like, I don't want to.
You really do. You really do.
And it took me forever.
Look, you're only one season behind on The Flash. It's on Netflix. All you have to do is watch it. That's it. That's it. It's 22 episodes. They're really good episodes.
The episode I saw was shit.
Okay. Well, I mean, that's the episode you saw. I like it. I enjoy it. I like the characters. It's the main reason.
How about this then? How about this?
What?
Before the next show, I'll watch the first three episodes.
Okay.
Yeah. That's fair. If I don't like it then, I'll come on next week's show and say it's shit.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Or I'm still watching it.
The thing I like about Flash is it's a different tone than Arrow. Like, Arrow's always dark and everything's... Flash is very positive. So
they're all young and that. They're all, like,
they're
really
all young.
Young.
Dude, they're all young. We're
it
old.
It reminds me of Buffy, you know?
We're old, dude. That's what happens. I watched an episode of Buffy this morning. I love Buffy. Why are we talking about TV? We're supposed to be talking about Buffy.
Because that's what we do.
All right.
Wayne? Anything to add, Wayne?
No.
I knew he was going
to... Well, let's get to your fucking story then. Segway.
Here we go. Let them in, let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away.
Man mutilated 21 vaginas and stored clitorises in freezer.
Clitorises!
It's frozen. All right, go ahead.
Go on,
Wayne. Read the rest.
You can out your system. I was letting the headline breathe.
I like the way you said clitorises rather than clitorises.
Both are correct.
It's true. You creepo. It's true. All right.
Wrong with a good clitoris. A man accused of severing vaginas of 21 women, including his wife's. So obviously he didn't want to go back there.
Right.
And storing parts of the freezer appeared in a South African court Wednesday, the BBC reported. This was back from May, so that's a bit out of date, but never mind. Peter Frederickson.
She was giving him lip.
Vagina lip. Peter Frederickson, a Denmark native living in Bloemfontein, South Africa.
South Africa.
Was greeted by
diplomatic immunity.
Was greeted by women activists from the African National Congress in a form of protest ahead of his bail application. We're here to make sure justice is served, Joyce Davidson.
No. That was not a South African
horrible. And it weren't a woman's voice either, but never mind. Shit happens. Frederickson was arrested in September after authorities said they found 21 clitorises.
That guy looks... Seriously, this guy looks fucked up.
What's up with the Danish? The Danish are a bit like that, aren't they?
Fucking weird, dude.
There's some fucking mass murderers over in Denmark and Sweden and that. Or Norway. That bloke killed fucking 150 people. No.
Go ahead, Wayne.
He whacked their beans nicely labeled plastic bags in his freezer.
That is not what they said in the article.
That to the story.
Fucking bullshit. That is not what they said in the article. What did they say?
Do you work for the Sun?
Said they found 21 clitorises neatly labeled in plastic bags in his freezer.
They worked for Rupert Murdoch.
They whacked their beans. He killed the little men in the boat.
In a statement cited by The Independent, police say the 63-year-old gun shop owner, so he's a nice reliable bloke, allegedly sedated his victims before performing illegal operations on them.
Most of his alleged
as opposed to legal vaginal removal.
Yeah, I know. Well, I mean, it is South Africa.
South Africa. Where'd you keep your beans? I keep my beans in the freezer.
I keep mine in the
freezer. She keeps his in the tin.
I keep mine in my asshole.
My beans in the freezer. Lips attached.
Most of his alleged Vincent.
No one cares. They're all probably black anyway.
He's a straight...
Oh, shit.
Jesus. Ignore that comment.
No, no, I don't mean it like no.
Francis.
No, I mean
not,
no.
Wait a minute. How did you not mean it like you said it?
No,
because nobody cares. They're black anyway.
I meant it as if it's South Africa, isn't it?
Did you mean it because they've got big lips?
He's apartheid white guy here. Isn't he? He's apartheid white bastard. So for him, he didn't care because he's white. That's what, and they're black.
His estranged wife.
I would hope.
Or now mutilated wife. Anna fuck that name. Also allegedly mutilated by Frederiksen. Was expected to testify at the trial, but was shot dead last month.
Holy shit. Well,
hang on.
Holy fuck. Are
so,
you serious?
No, hang on. So it said his estranged wife, Anna Matelzio Melis, was allegedly mutilated by Frederiksen, was expected to testify at the trial,
but
shot dead last month.
That's a bit of a coincidence, isn't it?
So he ripped her vagina off.
Well, her clit.
Do you reckon she'd have to get it out in court? Do you reckon she'd have to get it out in court if she made it?
Do you recognise this cunt?
Was this yours?
Yes,
plastic
I do.
Bag.
And that's
plastic and I all... bag gets lifted up.
Oh, don't. You've killed my joke because I was just about to...
Then they just lay it on the patch.
Just let me do my joke.
Flesh.
Just let me do my joke without fucking talking over me.
The plunge has come home.
I was going to do my joke without you talking over me, but the moment's lost now, I think.
So it's the plunge.
I was going to say, do you recognise this cunt? And she'd say, yes, and that's also my vagina over there.
See, what else, Wayne?
It's lost what now, else, wasn't Wayne? It? So he never actually murdered anyone. He was just mutilating their vaginas.
Yeah, he'd make them pass out and then he'd cut off
So
their
where were the
storm.
Other 20 fucking people?
That's what he's saying. That's what the rest of the story is. Go ahead, Wayne.
He denied it, and basically no suspect has been arrested for the murder of his wife.
But what's the other...
That's it. That's the end of the story.
Police are urging other victims to come forward. Frederiksen gunshot is totally unfound. Faces a slew of charges, including
okay,
sexual
he denied
assault,
it. No
violations
one's
of South
he
African
made
medicals.
Bow.
The Express noted no suspects. Is there. So he made bail.
Guy made bail.
How the fuck did he make? Dude, you can do anything you want in South
Africa. You fucking can. My friend, who is South African, because mum works in dentistry, and all the dentists over here are South African. I don't know why. They just are.
Claire's is Egyptian.
90%
of do you guys not make dentists over there anymore? Is that what it is?
Mine's English. She's quite fit.
You guys know
she's honestly about 30 and she's got like long black hair. She's quite fit, called Zoe.
Give her my number. He remembers their name.
Yeah, why don't you give her my number, dude?
I don't remember Claire's friend's name, but I remember my fit dentist.
Give her my number.
I was just hoping one day, like when like she's in my mouth, like over like they do, she just flops a tit into my mouth. That's never happened.
And this also sort of brings up my point with that they must have been black, because no one cares that there's 20 other vaginas missing in that town.
Well, I mean, to get on a serious note, why
did you go Canadian then?
Newt. On a serious note.
Newt.
Serious newt. Why
it doesn't matter if it's black or white.
Why wouldn't they come forward and why wouldn't they come forward?
Oh, don't they sell it?
They're poor. Okay. Yeah, it does matter.
Because they're poor? Why would that matter?
South Africa, it matters. Because he might have given them a few quid. Yeah, I'll rip your vagina off. It's 10 quid. Okay.
Do you think they face some type of reprisal?
Well, he is a gun shop owner.
He did kill his wife, or somebody killed his wife for him.
He blatantly killed his wife.
Obviously.
And he's got away with it. So, you know, if you want to murder someone, go to South Africa, I think, is the common consensus here. If you want to murder someone,
isn't South Africa the same place you can pay off a judge?
I'm pretty sure in most countries you can pay off a judge, but in South Africa I'd imagine it's even more rife. We've got our little Pistorius bloke who's
yeah, he got off.
He's not walking around because he's a fucking legless cunt.
He's bouncing. But, he's bouncing on his little bouncy legs.
Why don't they just take his legs off?
Well, he got out.
Legs new.
Wayne, he's out. He's free now. He
no,
killed.
He's not. He's under house arrest. Well, I keep
that's
telling
free.
It's the same fucking thing, man.
That's free.
It's free. You don't have to be in a prison getting butt fucked.
Wayne. If
but
someone
he's
said...
only he only got put there a couple of weeks ago.
Wayne, if someone said to you, right, you stay in your house for the next 2 years,
I'd be quite happy.
You got your TV. You got everything.
More unhappy.
All done. So would I be.
Yeah, you go
I'd
on a fucking
it.
Netflix bender, dude. You go on a bender for like
fuck
6 months. That's
you've got
all
your
you
laptop.
Do.
You've got your TV.
Everything you need.
Someone will deliver food for you.
Yes. That's it. What? It's all you need.
Give me house arrest. Give me
please
that.
Please do
I'll
that.
I fucking implore you yes. to give me that.
Watch out, Amy, next time you're in the bathroom and you hear noises from outside the door.
I'm going to rip Amy's clitoris off so I can get house arrest.
Not sure if that's going to go very well over at.
She just she looks a little bit scared right now.
I can imagine. Let's move on to the next story.
It's Wayne's Factory Break. It's love. Wayne's camp.
Everybody ready? It's time to
teach Wayne.
Come Wayne. On, learn me.
Come on, learn you. Good start.
Come on, eat me.
I shall teach you this fact, Wayne. Sarcasm is believed to boost creativity in all parties involved in the conversation.
I'm sure that's a really interesting fact.
Wow.
See what I did there? That was fucking sarcasm. Boom.
You didn't have to tell me. I understand yeah, sarcasm. I'm not American.
Hey.
True. There are a lot of American listeners out there, and we all know in the world that Americans don't get sarcasm.
I understand sarcasm just fine.
Of course you do.
Of course you do, mate.
Just because the British humor is nothing but sarcasm.
See, we just did it.
We just did it on you. We just done it on you.
Just because the sarcasm is nothing but British humor doesn't mean it's funny. That's all I'm saying.
Hilarious.
Oh, Americans are really funny.
We are funny. We actually have jokes. We think things through.
All you Americans do is go on about Seinfeld after all these years. That's
that is
all
not true.
God, that's
after all these years, that's your one claim to fame. Give it
that's
up.
Larry David as yes. well. You know,
yeah,
talking
that
about
is Larry David.
Enthusiasm.
Yes, thank
Seinfeld's
you.
Larry David as well. So.
Thank you.
But yeah, Americans are amazing, aren't they?
Sarcasm.
We
need a sarcasm alarm.
We Let are. Thank you, and we are.
I think it's the fact that the English are the kings of sarcasm. We are have it naturally ingrained in us.
Yeah,
because almost
form
every
of
sentence.
Wit.
Yes, because you guys have been around so long. You guys don't give a shit about anything.
I've only been around 29 years.
Yeah, he's only been around 29 years, mate.
I can Overall. Still do sarcasm.
You're awesome at sarcasm, Wayne.
No, he wasn't being sarcastic there, Chris. You see, you don't get it, do you?
Yeah, I was being sarcastic. But anyway, let's move on. Wayne.
What?
Your mother insult. Is found in nearly all cultures and is as old as humanity itself, with examples in Shakespeare and the Bible.
Even Stone Age.
Well, it's as old as humanity itself.
So, like, in the days where cave and fire, long-haired people, and they go, ooga booga booga, booga, your mother.
Ooga booga, mum. Ooga booga, cunt. Ooga booga.
The only thing I can imagine the Stone Age people doing is like the Stone Age man goes up to like your mother and rapes them in front of you. That's the only thing. That's not a very good mother joke.
Okay. Oh no, I've lost my train of thought now. Wayne.
What?
Every year, an estimated 4.68 million trees are used to make phone books. Nearly two-thirds of them end up in landfills.
There's no need for phone books now.
No, there isn't. There really isn't. Why are they a thing? Why the fuck are phone books a
and
thing?
And they're fucking big old things.
They're not really. We don't really do phone books.
I'll tell you why the phone books are things. Because phone book salesmen need a job and they go around to commercial companies and say, do you want a phone book?
Fucking old people can't use phones.
Wait, you have
do you
to
want to be in a phone
book? You have to buy your phone book?
No, you. No.
They used to get laid on your
free.
Doorstep.
But
do you remember that?
The reason the phone book companies make money is because they sell the advertising space. So there's phone book salesmen. And that's how there is. So if they're going to still make money off it, they're still going to make the phone books, aren't they? Companies need to go, well, no, because we've got our own website. We're all good.
Yeah, even the yellow pages like, around here, I don't even think of a website.
Yeah, I think it is.
Yale.com.
Yale.com.
Yeah, that's the Yellow Pages website. Yale.com. Another little fact. Wayne. Fuck phone books. Wayne, you need fucking phone books to stand on things and make yourself taller.
I've got ferret steps. That's fine.
What the fuck are ferret steps?
Well, we've nicknamed my grandmother. We call her Ferret, and she's got like little steps. And so we bought a load, and they're called ferret steps.
Can I ask why your grandmother's called Ferret?
Because she laughed at a program with ferrets on once.
What got her nickname.
And I've only ever known her. She's known Ferret, and sometimes, but when Mum speaks to her on the phone, she calls her Slump.
Why is she called Slump?
She's quite fat.
Fuck. Mum, you're a fat cunt.
No, she goes, Slump?
Yeah, well, she's saying, Mum, hello, Mum, you fat cunt.
It's affectionate.
And, yeah, you're that interested in that one time you laughed at a ferret on TV, so well, that's your nickname. That's how she uninteresting you are as a human being. Why don't you drop down dead so I can get your fucking money from your house?
In your
head. Thing is, she gets quite angry when I put it in the Christmas cards.
I can imagine. Well,
you call a fat cunt in the Christmas card?
No, I call it. I put ferret and granddad.
We'll just call her Nan. Nan and granddad, mate.
No, that was the other one that died. She was Nana.
So what?
Just call her grandma.
This is his bit on the side after your Nan died.
No, ferret's what alive. Then? You have two sets of grandparents.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Jack and Nan are dead. Ferret and granddad are alive.
Oh, so you got, right. So why are you sending one card to opposite sides of the family?
I'm not.
I love how he's...
Ferret and granddad.
Grim.
But granddad, you said granddad's on... Your nan's dead on... Granddad's...
Yeah, Nana's dead. Nana's dead.
Right, okay. Is granddad married to Ferret?
Granddad and Ferret, yeah. They're still alive.
Your other set of grandparents are dead.
Yes.
So why? It goes back to my original thing, then, doesn't it? Why? So you said granddad. So why don't you just say granddad and Nan? Nan and granddad.
She's dead.
Oh my fucking god! I'm gonna smash this fucking. I'm gonna smash it. I'm gonna smash this phone in a minute.
Move on.
Wayne.
Yeah.
In Japan, Ronald McDonald is called Donald McDonald due to the lack of clear R sounds in Japanese. Oh, we don't know R.
They have a very hard time.
Donald McDonald.
R.
Donald McDonald. Not one. It's Ronald.
Ronald McDonald.
Ronald.
Yeah. How do they say my name?
Ronald.
How do they say my name? Whenever I book a table, I can't remember how they say my name, but they all say my name the same.
Edwards.
Ah, Mr. Edwards.
Mr. Edwards.
No, they don't. They say it somehow. I can't.
Edwards.
They struggle with it every time.
Edwards. Edwards.
I ain't got no R's in my name, mate. I'm good.
I'm good. Fucked. Mr. Quiz.
So's old Vampy. Vampy's good as well.
Yeah, Vamp is good.
But your real name's good. My real name's good. Your real name's fuck, yeah, Wayne. If you went to Japan, they'd hate you for all the
Mr.
R's.
Wayne, come right in, Mr. Wayne.
Mr. Wayne, change your name.
Mr. Wayne.
The Asians love me.
The Asians don't love you. Amy says she hates you. Just like Claire hates me, apparently. Claire, this was off air, people, but... apparently Claire doesn't like me. I think I'm a bad influence on Wayne.
You're a bad person.
I'm gonna go ahead and say that my next girlfriend's not.
But Amy.
Stop talking about your hand. Your hand loves him.
Look who's talking.
Amy likes you. So you know she likes one of you better than the other.
I'd fuck Amy.
You might want to fuck Amy. I don't think Amy would want to fuck you, Chris.
Yeah, that's...
She's not in our head.
She is. I've told her before. She's definitely the best looking.
I can imagine Amy's face at the thought of it as like a child having medicine.
Gotta take your medicine, though. It's a must. You have to take it.
I don't know why Claire don't like me, Wayne. We'll do that for another show.
Please,
maybe a special.
Can we?
Can we do that
like
for like
five
a special?
Hour spectacular?
Why doesn't Claire like? We could get you could be like the mediator,
Jerry Springer at the end of it,
and Claire could be at one saying why she don't like me, and then I could be, you know. Shall I move on, Wayne?
What?
Yes, Daddy. In Spanish, the word esposas means both wives and handcuffs.
sounds like a chicken dish.
What, esposas?
Esposas.
You go in there on a Friday night and order a Porsche esposas.
Esposas.
Esposa.
So nice.
Say it again, Wayne. Esposas.
Espinosa.
That's a name.
So yes, that means both wives and handcuffs.
Makes
what do you
sense.
Think?
Makes sense to me.
Marriage isn't a word. It's a fucking sentence.
So if a copper nicks you and says, I'm putting you in wives, you need to run away.
I'm putting you in esposas today.
Why is he gay?
He's gay. Why is he gay? Why is he a generic Mexican gay man?
I don't know.
I'm putting you in esposas.
Imagine some esposas. Fucking village people.
Esposas.
Come join us in esposas.
Wayne.
You can have a cock-sucking cowboy too.
Wait, well, we know you like cock-sucking cowboys, Wayne. You've had
got three Johnnies that night. Shut your mouth.
Okay.
Tell me to shut my mouth because he got free condoms because he bought a cock-sucking cowboy. What did I drink in that place?
You had one of my cock-sucking cowboys.
I had a taste of your cock-sucking cowboy, but what was I drinking in that place? Pint. A pint, like a man. Suck. Like a man drinks a pint. I don't need to hide my sexuality. If people want to think I'm gay, that's fine. You had to, like, make sure that people thought you was gay by buying cock-sucking cowboy fucking cocktails. Look at me!
I just like stuff as creamy, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you do like things creamy. Creamy running down your throat. Nice and hot, coming out of a cock. Wayne?
I ain't tried Bailey's chocolate yet. What?
You'd like Bailey's fucking... Is Bailey a teaser, is he? John Bailey. You'd like his chocolate cream down your throat. Hello, I'm John Bailey.
Why are they your impression of a...
Tyrone Bailey. He wants to put coffee cream down your throat, Wayne. He wants a throat fuck, yeah. Tyrone. Wayne. Wayne. You fucking faggot. Wayne.
What?
If you search for askew in Google, the content will tilt slightly to the right.
Fuck up. Go fuck and fuck
up.
Off.
Fuck up. What does fuck up mean?
What?
So go into Google. Fuck yes. Go into Google. Type askew.
I can't get out of Google Drive.
And it shall tilt. Google. It will go askew. Just into your searcher. Into your searcher.
I can't get out of Google Drive.
Fuck's sake. Jesus.
Oh my God. Come on.
Oh, there's a tab here. No.
Oh, mate. I'm moving on, Wayne.
No, I'll log out.
This is cringeworthy, isn't it? It really is cringeworthy.
Can we move on, please?
Yeah, I want to, but he won't let me, will he? He'll just keep going on about it. Wayne, have you done it yet?
Is it skew?
What? Why would it be skew, you fucking flid?
Hey,
it's
skew.
Askew. It's a skew, as in tilted. A skew.
Oh, my God!
Not... Yes, it worked, did it?
Ugh!
Did it work?
That's weird. It's on the her.
It's on the her. There you go. Wayne.
Asleep.
Wayne.
What?
Wayne!
What?
Fucking hell. This one's nice and topical. Paris syndrome is a psychological disorder mainly suffered by Japanese people caused after realizing that Paris isn't exactly what they expected.
That's a real syndrome?
Paris syndrome, yeah. Huh. So you've got Stockholm syndrome, obviously, which is if you're captured and things by someone and then you start to love your capturer. That's Stockholm syndrome.
Stockholm.
But Paris syndrome... is someone that if you go to a place and you're like, well, like you're really hyped up for it and you're like, yeah, oh, this is going to be awesome. And you're like, it's not really that awesome. Like, and that's called Paris syndrome.
Every video game.
Because Paris is never as good as you thought it was going to be, especially when bombs are getting off.
Especially when bombs and fucking people are getting
off. It will have been a week when this gets released. It'll be fine. But as we're recording this, it's like yesterday.
2 days. We're horrible people.
We are just cunts. We're cunts, but yeah.
What do you think, Wayne?
Paris was dirty when I went. They had to wash the streets. They had little hoses.
That sounds like an Alan Bennett poem. I don't know what you
They had
you
little
doing.
Hoses come up and clean the streets.
Right.
Because they're so dirty.
Well, they have that in every town and city across the country. I don't know what your point is.
Yeah, not there's... Little, yeah, there's
I don't in Ipswich.
Street cleaners.
Street cleaners, sweepers.
No, Ipswich
and
is a shithole. That's like, why they just fucking leave.
No,
Ipswich
they have the van things go around cleaning the street, but these actually have things that come out the road and do it.
Okay,
the road.
So they're a little bit more advanced than Ipswich. Imagine that. Paris is more advanced than Ipswich.
Wayne.
Yeah. I don't know what to say.
In Greek mythology, it is believed that redheads turn into vampires when they die.
What?
8 minutes silence now. What? I'd love it if we kept... One time, just kept sciences in. In Greek mythology...
What do they know? It's all myth.
Yep.
It is
Very
myth.
Good.
That's
Very
why
good.
It's mythology. It was believed that redheads turn into vampires when
they
die.
But they don't. How is
but
that
in
a
Greek
fact?
What do you mean?
Redheads do not turn into vampires.
But in Greek mythology, they do.
a lot of bullshit.
That's like saying that's like saying Jesus in the Bible can turn water into wine. It's just a fact.
I like that because I'm a big fan of vampires and I'm down.
But neither of them are gonna suck you.
Heavy set. Heavy set. Suck him off.
Yeah. Heavy.
You get sucked off by heavy set.
Heavy.
Heavy set will eat you for breakfast, mate.
Syrup.
I'd rather a mop jockey jumping on down my cock, to be honest. Nice big boy like him.
Alright, what's next one?
Yeah. My name's not Wayne, by the way. That's
you've done this several times during this episode. You've called me Ant and called him Wayne.
I don't know what's going on.
You're like an old person that just can't get the names
right.
Give
me a fucking break. I don't know.
And I don't know why all of a sudden he's trying to make me move on. Like, I don't know when to move on. Like, he's trying to make...
I apologize.
Come on, Bill. Shut up.
Wayne?
Yes. Yes, Ant.
Oh, thank you, Wayne. The word pencil comes from a Latin word meaning small penis.
Pencil dick. Is that where that comes from?
Possibly.
I'm sure it does. You hear that a lot, Wayne?
Is that what you used to get? Is that what you used to get called, is it?
Well, the German bloke made the toilet was called crapper.
He was. And that's why you go to the crapper.
Yep.
Yep. Well done. Thanks for that fact.
Silence.
Thanks for that fact. Right, let's move on. This is the last fact. Thank fuck, as usual. Wayne. Now, I always run my facts by Amy, okay? And she says, yeah, don't use that one.
Sure, facts.
Don't use that one. Now, she loves my facts.
Is this the coup de grace?
Yeah, it's the last one. He just said, damn it.
It's the last one. He must have just learned that word.
I think he did, yeah. But, he finally learned.
And he wanted to slip it in somewhere. Somewhere in the podcast, he wanted to slip that in.
I have an idea. I'm gonna
and that was his opportunity.
I'm going to learn coup de grace. I'm going to use it today on the podcast.
Right. Now, Wayne, this what? Is using... You got right. So this is using the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... all in the right order to make 100, okay? So there's four ways of doing it, and this is fascinating. So 123, take away 45, take away 67, plus 89 equals 100. 123 plus 4, take away 5, plus 67, take away 89 equals 100. 123, take away 4, take away 5, take away 6, take away 7, plus 8, take away 9 equals 100, and 1 plus 23, take away 4, plus 5, plus 6, plus 78, take away 9, equals 100.
There's only four ways.
There's only four ways, I know, but I just thought that was quite cool.
So there could be more.
Might be.
So that's not a fact. Then.
Well, it's a fact that the ways I've just told you make it 100.
You said there's a fact that there's four ways, but there could be five.
Could be five.
What's the fifth?
I've just told you four ways of doing it.
What's the fifth?
I don't know. Leave that for the listeners to do.
All right.
Give them some fucking homework.
I think it might be only four ways, but, you know.
Everyone likes a good five-way, though.
You've never been in a three-way, never mind a four-way
or a
four and a five-way.
Way or a five.
Have you ever had a threesome way?
No.
So why are you bragging about a five-way?
I'm not. I'm saying everyone likes a five-way.
His wife's...
I didn't say I was
no
going
to.
His wife's about to have
any
a three-way.
Human... What? Yeah, his missus is out of five. Aunt Claire loves a five-way. She's down in Stowe. Fucking
spoon.
Down at the Weatherspoons. Fucking under the table with that geezer sucking her off. With three lesbians attached to her. Fatal five-way. Boom.
That'd be five, yeah.
Yeah, it would be. And you wouldn't be invited. Wayne, why don't you go upstairs? I'll go upstairs and wank. Yeah. All right. Thanks. All right. Cheers. Thanks. She walks upstairs. Boom, 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 boom. Straight on Skype call. Let's have a wank off five-way. Woohoo! Wayne's not invited.
Everybody show your genitals.
If they're all that mongy bloke on Facebook, I don't want to wank over that.
I don't know. You look better than you.
Wow.
All right. I guess we're going to move on.
What a weird ending.
I don't know if that was a question.
What, me saying he's better looking than you?
It's a little rough. It's a little rough.
Why is that rough?
A little rough.
That won't.
All right. Well, let's move on.
The fuck is this?
Oh, fuck up, you don't know Arcade Fire.
I know, like, one track.
Oh.
So that was Arcade the
Chief. I only know Wake Up. Like, that's the main one, isn't it, that they've done?
I don't know. I don't know most of them.
Well, what's their main? Rebellion Lies.
Just going for the first album.
No, I'm saying their main two records.
Yeah, they've never, like Wim Butler says when they headlined thingy, Glastonbury, he turned around and go, how come we're headlining festivals over here? That is true. They've never had a hit song, but their albums have been massive.
I think I only know...
So unless you've actually sat down and listened to an album.
I'd say by name, I only know two of their records. Rebellion Lies and Wake Up. They're the only two records I can categorically say that I know by name.
I couldn't name an album, but I do know who they are.
You must know Reflector, because that was the one.
Yes,
off their latest.
Yes, Reflector. But again, like, if you played it to me, I'd be like, oh, yeah, of course. But like, straight off my head, like I just did, I wouldn't know.
So this is the hot button topic for this week, guys. Transgender. We were trying to do it last week, but we kind of didn't. This is the hot button topic, and we're going to talk about transgender. So the first article we're going to talk about is transgender woman sent to all-male prison loses appeal. So I don't really want to go into it deep, but what do you guys think about transgender people going to the prison given genitalia are?
I don't know, because you get a lot of raping at prisons, don't you? I mean, I would be fucked if I go down.
You drop the soap.
I'm fucked.
You don't need to drop the soap, Wayne. It just happens to soap at
I'm
all.
Getting raped. I am getting raped. Yeah.
Why don't they have soap on a rope? That'll cut rape down in prison, though. And
transgender.
I'm a little bit worried that I'm now a prison officer.
I will say this: this woman looks like a woman.
Yes, she does look like a woman.
She does, dude.
And she got
legit
refused entry into the female prison.
Yep.
That has now been overturned since this story came out. That has now been overturned, and they've overturned it. So it's the first time in history in Britain that a male person is...
So she's going to a female prison?
They are, yeah, now. Good. Yeah. Good. So,
dude, she
which
would...
I think is right. I think's right. You know, if you've got... If you look like a woman, you think you're a woman.
Oh my god.
I'm looking at her right now, dude. She would be multiple. I mean, she would be raped if she went to a male prison. Oh my god, it would be horrendous.
Can you imagine someone looking like that in a male prison? It's not even worth thinking about.
Yeah,
not the amount of security that the prison has to go through to, you know, attend to that person so nothing happens would be incredible. So you might as well just put her in a female prison. Yeah.
It's
nonsense.
Tara Hudson, 26, has lived as a woman all her adult life and has undergone 6 years of gender reconstruction. She's still legally a man. The makeup artist was handed a 12-week jail term by magistrates after Boxing Day assault, which led to her being sent to an all-male prison. She launched an appeal against her sentence, which was heard before Bristol Court, Crown Court, on Friday. A panel of three judges led by... Recorded Louis Selick dismissed her appeal after ruling that she had worrying criminal record.
She's a good looking woman.
She's a very good looking woman.
And I say woman in the proper terms. Mm. She is a woman.
Yeah.
She thinks she's a woman. She's a transgender. Do you know why you've got nipples? And I'll throw that out to Wayne.
I don't know why I've got.
Do you know why boys have nipples? Because in the womb, we all start out as female. Everyone starts out as a female. So transgender, to me, is just a way of saying that something went wrong on that stage. That, like, I've got no issue with it.
Quote,
people go fucking mental over it, especially, like, Western religious types.
We'll get into that in a minute. Quote, as she left the prison today to come to court where she was placed in a female cell, she found herself taunted by other inmates. Tara, show us your... You're telling me she's not going to get raped in all fucking...
Look at her. I mean,
absolutely.
I know she's a man and I'd fuck it.
Well, she's undergone reconstructive surgery, so more than likely she doesn't genitalia.
It's got turned inside out.
Yeah, six years. 6 years is a long time ago.
You know, for fuck's sake, you cannot take someone like that in a male prison with 300 people with high tech a living. It's stupid. Or you know, the only other argument, and it's a fair one, would be to start a transgender prison.
I'm not against. Well, in CB-
but it costs. Who's it going to cost money? It's going to cost us money.
Yeah,
but,
of course.
You know, and there's going to be what 20 people in the prison.
Yeah,
but
I mean,
that will
be
the only
smallest prison ever.
That will be the only other option to get away from.
Well, the other thing is that Houston, Texas, rejecting transgender bathroom touts call for the day after votes in Houston, Texas defeated a measure dubbed to many of being the bathroom bill aimed at protecting gay and transgender people from discrimination. Wednesday seemed lit into those who overwhelmingly opposed the measure by touting fears of Houston businesses being boycotted and even 2017 Super Bowl being moved out of the failure to pass. Anchor Scott Pettinger started by diatribe by explaining the final margin was 61% to 39% against the ordinance to ban discrimination in housing based on age, sex, or genital identity.
Right. Can you explain this a bit more in British terms for me?
Yes.
So I can understand
so
it.
The bill was to make it illegal for anyone that is a transgender, gay, or age to be discriminated against for housing or rights to bathrooms.
So going into a toilet cubicle.
Correct. Or housing. It also has a housing attack.
Wow, your country is so backwards.
Isn't it?
Because I remember something here about, God, it must have been about 15 years ago. No, early 2000s. And something similar cropped up and it killed the whole thing off and it got passed through. That anyone that's transgender can go in any fucking toilet they want to. So in this country, it's go where you want.
Yeah,
like that. That is
this is exact. Well, this is the problem. So like reading this, the measure was called the Houston Equal Rights Ordinance, but opponents dubbed it the bathroom and made the name stick through a series of ads that claim women and children will become vulnerable to sexual predators in the ladies' room.
It's just bollocks.
Yeah, exactly. That was
so
completely
a sexual
bullshit.
Predator has to dress up in a wig, dress up as a woman, go into a toilet cubicle, and then put a camera.
If he's that crazy, he'd rape regardless of sneaking into the bathroom.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're absolutely right. This is like, and you know, I won't read any more of the article, but this is my thing. Like, I saw an article on Facebook saying that you don't want transgender women in your in my bathroom. I agree. I don't want a woman in my bathroom.
Fucking hell, Wayne gets stage fright now.
Can you imagine? Stood
fucking next to him.
Fuck yes.
Can you imagine if it's a fucking beautiful woman with a cock bigger than his?
Oh my God, I could just. Oh, can you imagine?
What would you do?
Not an issue because I'd always go in a cubicle anyway.
Wow. Yeah.
You never go in a urinal?
I've seen you go in a urinal.
If there's no one there, then I go. But if there's company, then.
I've stood next to you in a urinal. Yeah, in a urinal.
I can't go.
Did you not go when I was the next year?
I'd probably act half the time I'm acting.
Oh.
Acting?
You pretend shake, go out, and then you hold it for about another 10 minutes and try again.
Wow. Have you got a really small penis?
No, I just can't do it. I can't piss in public.
Why can't I? Okay.
What's the difference between holding it out and pretending to piss? There's absolutely no difference. That's
so,
not the fear
exactly,
of my
so you
penis
might as well
size.
Piss.
I physically can't get the piss out.
So
I don't know what it is. It's like a block.
Wayne, I want you to explain what a train
thingy is. One that's going through the change, you know?
Going through the change? They don't have to be going through.
So it's just a transvestite?
No,
transvestite
is a transvestite. It's a man or a woman dressed as...
Yeah, but transgender is when they change.
No.
No, they could always be the same. Mm-hmm. They could always be a boy or a girl. Mm-hmm. And they just, in the wrong body.
Correct.
You know.
Yeah, when you get a man trapped in a woman's body.
Yeah.
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 That's what I'm trying to say. I might be saying it very badly.
Or
that's
a woman
what I'm trying.
Or a man trapped in a woman's body.
That's what I was trying
to say. So, Wayne, what's a shemale?
Oh, my God, shemale. That's like Japanese. Stereotypical,
you
I know.
You're such a piece of shit.
But
Japanese. Thailand.
Yes.
You got the wrong country.
Oh, what was that on fucking Bangkok?
Like, Bangkok is not in Japan, mate.
Bangkok nope. Lady Boys. Now I'm trying to think of Alan Partridge episode where he ordered the porn on his TV.
Yes, which is Bangkok, which is in Thailand.
So Wayne, we're gonna do a transgender test.
Shemale is basically a thingy, a woman looking thing with a dick.
I've got a dick.
So we're gonna do a transgender test with you, okay?
So what's
Wayne?
A lady boy?
Wayne, what's a lady boy?
It's I thought that's the same thing.
Pretty much, but definitely from Dylan.
Definitely.
Right, oh, good. Oh,
so the transgender test went.
What?
All right, so first and foremost, do you really want to be the opposite?
Particularly?
No, I want you to think about that.
Why not particularly?
I want you to think about that, okay? You like women, right? You like women, right, Wayne?
Yeah.
You like to masturbate to women because you want to feel and touch a vagina, right?
I don't want a dick in me.
No, that's not what I'm asking. It's not what I'm asking.
But okay? If I was a woman, if you I'd was want a dick in me.
No, that's not true. That's not true at all. Some transgender...
Did you just say, I want a dick in me?
Somebody please cut.
That's being cut. I want a dick in me.
Now you just said...
Yeah, so, but I said it laughingly. That's not then it loses
so,
the thing.
Wayne, okay. I want you to
dick in me.
Wayne, I want you to understand that if you want a vagina, you can
so you
always
want me
have one.
To say I'm a gay woman.
No, that's not you what I'm
that's what you're trying to get me
no,
to
that's
say.
That's not what I'm saying. A gay woman.
Because then I'd be
just
a
like
woman.
Johnson.
I'd be a woman, but don't want a dick in me.
So is that no, I'm fine with the social role I was born with. Or
can
I think
play
about
this game. Where can I find this game?
OKCupid.com.
You said I click the link and I can't do it. Sexuality spectrum test.
Take the transgender test. You just look up trans on Google.
Okay.
So all is that a no? I'm fine with the social role I was born with, Wayne. So second question: do you dislike or even hate your gender, secondary sex, sexual character? No, I didn't. Do you dislike or even hate your genitalia / secondary sexual characteristics?
Is that in English?
No, they don't bother me. The fact that they are annoying bothers me, but I'm not sure if I want to change them or remove them. I don't feel.
Do
they
I find my cock annoying?
Yes.
No, it's my best friend.
Why so do
just,
you want
just,
to?
Why can't I play this as well?
You can if you want. Yeah, play along.
So
I can only ask one person. I can only ask one person.
Well, no, you ask one person. Okay. Ask both of them.
Okay.
Do you dislike or even hate your genitals? Mm-hmm. I love my fucking.
So no, they don't bother you. Why do you want to be the opposite sex?
I don't.
No, you do.
There you go. That is actually an option.
Do you feel urges to express certain aspects and or traits of femininity or masculinity? So do you feel the need to express certain aspects of femininity?
I eat chocolate, but...
So it'd be sometimes it just builds up over time and I need to find a way to express it.
No.
Sometimes you do that like a little bitch.
Yeah. Quite often I get upset when I'm in a situation where I cannot express my gender identity. I think that
oh,
sounds right.
Oh, fucking hell. Vamp's the right bitch. He's such a crier.
Crying is not for femininity.
It is.
Aunt, what do you say?
I actually put sometimes.
I think Wayne is quite often I get upset when I...
Sometimes I feel a bit girly. Like
I do too.
You know, when shit gets me down, mm-hmm. like people know I suffer from depression and that, and I feel like, oh, fucking hell, you're acting like a pussy. Mm-hmm. That means I'm acting a bit girly, doesn't it? So...
How do you feel when you see members of the opposite sex? When
hard.
I feel indifferent to them in regards of gender. I wonder what it would be like to be them. I feel upset that I was not born the member of their sex. I feel overwhelmingly jealous or angry, and it brings my...
What was the first one?
I wonder what it'd be like to be like...
That one is probably okay. The closest out of those three. Right.
How far would you go to transition into your desired sex as far as any members... I would not want to change anything as long as all my family members are cool with it. I wouldn't mind losing a few friends and family, but it's worth it. I have to give up them all or no prices.
I don't want to be one.
So you don't.
Yeah,
so
but no,
as long as your family,
social thing.
But as long as your family members and friends are cool with it, you'd be there, right?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
I put no prices too high when it comes to being myself.
I agree.
Like, no. Fuck it. If, yeah. It's about me. It's about me,
exactly,
damn it.
Exactly.
No price is too high when it comes to being me, myself. And that's how I want to be. And that's 100%. How I want to live my life. So fuck everyone else.
100%. If you could temporarily go back to before you were born, would you choose to have sex?
Oh, that's a good one.
I would not change anything. I'm okay with this I was born with.
That one. I'm quite happy being a man.
You've never thought about being a woman, ever.
You can think about it, but that's not what that's saying.
So you have thought about being a woman.
It's only very personally.
But you have...
I've actually sat there and thought about it for about 10 minutes. No.
So, but you have thought about it.
What's the option with thinking about it, then?
Have we got prior knowledge?
Well, yeah, of course. You're thinking about the overall... your lifespan.
So if I could temporarily go back. Okay.
Yeah. If you could temporarily go
if
back.
If I could temporarily go back, I'd go back as a woman.
You would go back as
a woman. Fuck yeah, because this completely different. It's alien to me. It'd be quite nice to know what it's like.
So, Wayne, you would not change.
I think the key word is the temporarily.
So, Wayne, you would not change anything but still choose to have feelings of being the opposite.
What?
So you would you not choose anything? You would not change your sex, but you would choose to never have feelings of being the opposite. I would choose not to change anything, but I would still choose to have feelings of being the opposite. Or I would not change anything. I'm okay with the sex I was born with.
I wouldn't change anything. I'm happy with the sex I am.
Okay. How do you feel when a member of the opposite sex stereotypes your behavior or beliefs to be typical of sexual...
Half the time, the stereotypical jokes are true, aren't they?
So you don't feel... Or you feel bothered and self-conscious to behavior.
No, quite the opposite.
So you take pride in being
a... Just laugh at it.
So you take pride in being associated with behaviors of genetics.
Yeah, probably.
And what about you?
What was the question? How do you feel when a member of the opposite sex stereotypes your behavior or beliefs?
Like when a woman says that a man can't do two things at once, that sort of shit.
Yeah.
Okay, so the options are, I take pride in being associated with behaviors. I feel bothered, upset. I don't feel upset or outraged. Fucking hell.
How dare you make a joke?
That's like having a vagina. I feel bothered or self-conscious. No, I take pride in being associated with the behaviors of my genetic sex.
All right, let's go to the next question. Number 9, if you express your gender identity by wearing clothes typical to the opposite sex, why? Identity in another way, just yourself for your expression. I do not feel the need to express myself as a member of the
That's
him. That's him.
Wait, you've never dressed up in a dress or a skirt?
I've done drag ones.
For Halloween and stuff, but that's not because I wanted to express myself.
You've never wanted to see how feminine I can make myself look?
No.
Never.
Did I ever tell you the story of my singing at school? So I was always a very good singer at school. I'd like to think I still am, but I ain't no more. I listened to myself earlier and I thought it was horrific. Yeah. But anyways, I was... Me and my friend Dean... We had a bit of a fallout. Dean. I'm talking, we were 11, because this is primary school. So it was 10 or 11. And they had a audition for the songs. Like, you can sing songs for the concert at Christmas time. And the concert was 1970s disco, which is fine, you know. And so me and Dean had a little fallout. And I said, do you know what? His girlfriend was Michelle. I said, I'm going to fucking... Because she wanted to do the song. I said, I'm going to go up against her and I'll fucking win, mate. I think I actually said that exactly like that as well, even as a 10-year-old. So I auditioned for it and it was a Donna Summer. First I was afraid, I was petrified, and I got it. And the whole thing was on the concert, my mum and all the parents were fucking surrounding me, putting makeup on me in drag. I'm only 10, 11 years old. And the whole shtick was at the end of the song, I took my little wig off. So that was, and I did. I actually had a punch up with Dean over that and I gave him a bloody nose and he cried. So fuck off, Dean.
Fuck you,
Goddard,
Dean.
From Dagenham. So you can go fuck yourself because I beat you up when you was 10. So fuck you. And, but yeah, and I won. And I took my hat and I took my wig off, and that was my first time in drag. Nice. And my parents always thought I was gay, even up when I split up. I used to have girlfriends a lot, like coming and going, but I never used to like put it in my parents' face, like who I was having sex with and stuff.
My
parents always thought I was gay. And I went out for a meal when I got with Leanne, who was my major relationship before Amy, and they said, "Aunt, like, we're quite..." This is my mum after a few drinks. My dad didn't say this. She went, "We thought you were gay."
Yeah.
Said, why? Because I don't bring girls home and fuck them in your house. Why would I do that?
You know? My parents thought I was gay too.
You are. You haven't had sex for like 3 years.
3 years. Wayne, how do you or would you feel when a relative stranger tells you that belief that you have or behavior you have? Would you be offended, indifferent, complimented, or it makes your day?
Makes my day.
You'd be indifferent, right?
Well, does that mean
normal? Yeah, indifferent.
Indifferent is normal.
Yeah, it's normal. It's like, bah, whatever.
Meh.
All right. How do you think?
Makes my day.
Yeah.
Someone says to me, "I ain't." That was a bit That was a bit womanly.
Yeah, wicked. How do you feel when a relative stranger thinks you are a member of the app? Do you feel indifferent, offended, good for a while, it makes you happy?
What happened when I was a baby? I was about a month.
Why don't you come to the mic, Wayne?
I am.
Sorry. It would help, wouldn't it?
When sorry, I had to stand because I got a square ass.
When you were 1 year old? Yeah, but Wayne, we all look the same when we're one. We all look like...
Well, yeah, other than that, I've never had it.
Never had it?
No.
So you're just indifferent?
Yeah.
It makes me happy.
As a kid, how often would you play the kids with sex? Would you sometimes do it? You never did it? Always torn between them? Or always wanted to play the kids?
You'd always do like the girl thing, like, ooh, hello. Yeah,
exactly. like Monty Python.
Hello.
Yeah, you'd always do that shit.
Yeah, I would do it too.
I don't think any kids could say they never did that.
Yeah, it would be sometimes, right?
It's got to be sometimes.
Wayne, did you sometimes play as the opposite sex?
I quite often sing as the female on karaoke.
So that I would...
He's torn.
Wayne, have you ever deliberately physical harm to your genitals?
What the fuck?
No!
No, okay.
What the fuck is that about?
Cut my dick off.
All right, Wayne, what...
Slash my dick.
Well, whatever. If you just physical harm. It's like punch
trap
your dick.
Trap it in a door.
Just squeeze your bollocks. My bollocks are too big to squeeze anyway.
Wayne.
What?
If you do not wear clothing of the opposite sex, select the answer that best explains why.
Okay.
I feel wrong and I would not want to wear clothing of the opposite. I want to, but I don't and won't because of social prejudice. I want to and plan to because I need to find the courage and motivation to do it. Or I want to and plan to and I'm dying to, but I have some coming out.
I'd feel uncomfortable.
You would feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Okay. Is I just feel
you would
wrong.
Feel wait, you would feel uncomfortable because of social pressure or you would feel uncomfortable because you're
I'd feel uncomfortable because I don't like the feel of skirts and shit.
Skirts feel nice, man. Oh, man. Actually, you get the air up your legs.
Absolutely.
I just wouldn't feel right.
You wouldn't feel right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Do you or would you undergo hormone replacement therapy in which a doctor prescribes hormones?
So I can get tits.
Sex? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't need a hormone.
No, so, not for me.
So there'd be no way. Only
no,
if it did
I wouldn't
not
pump.
Take
I very rarely
budget.
Pump shit into my body anyway.
Okay. All right.
He rarely does fucking exercise, never mind fucking pumping shit into it.
Let's say you're 60 years old.
When's the last time you went done any exercise?
I don't know. I go swimming.
When? When's the last time you went swimming?
A couple of weeks ago.
When?
About 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago. How long for?
Probably about an hour.
Where?
Fucking hell. What do you want? A fucking address? Put it in your sat-nav?
I just don't believe you. Fucking I don't believe hell. You do exercise.
Wayne, let's say you are 60 years old. Would you not transition because of your age, even if part of you wanted to?
What?
Let's say you're 60 years old, but let's say you are.
Let's say. It's fucking said let's say.
Say. Would you, if you were a transgender person and you were 60 years old, would you want to transition because it's worth it? Would you want
you've
to because 60 it's...
60 years, there's no point, is there?
Why not?
No point.
Boom. Right, I've got a fucking story about this because okay. I hope they don't
if
listen.
If you felt that strongly, you would have done something before.
Nah,
then.
Fuck off, Wayne. Fuck off. You don't know what you're talking about. But
obviously not, because I'm not transgender.
Well, exactly. So you don't know what you're talking about.
So I don't know why you're making me take the quiz.
But Caitlyn Jenner is older than 60, and she transitions.
So I've got a friend. A couple of my friends are in their 60s. Okay. And one of those was getting married. Mm-hmm. Jonathan Kappa, my friend Jonathan Kappa, was getting married. And I've spoken about him before. He got married to a Thai lady. Mm-hmm. And his best man... Was a gentleman who at the time was 65 years old going through a sex change.
Oh, okay.
Just came out. But 65, Wayne. Yeah. 65.
James Randi.
And there was a point during the wedding where we thought, is this going to be a best man or is this going to be a best woman? And it was honestly like a touch and go, like, because it was sort of bang on. 65 years old, Wayne. Yeah. 65.
James Randi didn't come till he was. Yeah.
I personally, my option on this is it's never too late to bring your body in harmony with your soul.
I agree.
That's my option on this one.
So, Wayne, would you, because if you were in good health, Would you because you're possible medical problems, or you wouldn't because you're possible medical problems, or you're too...
But whenever I felt the need to change it. Well, I don't know what you're trying to ask. I'm not in this situation. So, I can't answer it because I'm not in the fucking situation.
It is a hypothetical question.
It's a hypothetical question.
I wouldn't have done it when I was 60 because I'd have done it earlier if I felt the need to.
All right.
You keep asking me. I'm giving you an answer.
No,
then you're like, well,
that's not an answer. That's not an answer. Saying because I don't want to play your game is not an answer. All right. Which of these is most important to you when it comes to how people perceive you? Being perceived and treated as a member of the opposite sex. Being perceived and treated as someone without a particular gender label, merely different. Being perceived and treated as a transgendered person, or being perceived treated as...
What were the first two?
Being perceived and treated as a member of the opposite sex, or being perceived
and
treated...
Does that mean opposite? Does that mean male or female for me?
What sex are you?
I'm male.
So you would be opposite of that would be...
I don't want to be female.
Okay. So being perceived and treated as someone with particular without a particular gender label and merely different...
That would be mine.
I agree. I don't necessarily need to be treated like a man or a female.
I don't think it's about man and female.
Yeah, I'd rather be treated as me, necessarily. So, Wayne, would you be treated as your sex?
I just said the second one that you spoke over.
Being perceived as treated as someone without particular...
Moody.
Well, I am, because you're not even listening now.
He's getting moody. He's getting moody, man.
I'm trying to answer.
Those replacement hormone therapies must be kicking
in. He's trying to answer.
How do you perceive yourself? As a member of the sex you were born with? As a member of the sex I was born with who wants to become the opposite sex? As a transgender person? Or as the member of the opposite?
A member of the sex I was born.
Okay. How far do you want to take your transition? I don't want to go...
I don't want to transition!
There you go, he's gone top one.
He's gone the first one. If you are in a situation where you have to present as your biological sex, how much of an effort is it to keep it from bothering?
Is it a bother? Not a bother?
Moderately a bother?
Little bit of a bother? Or a definite bother?
Bother to do what?
To be treated as the sex you were born with.
Not a bother at all.
Okay, let's see how we're at.
Let's see where we're going
now. There was only a couple of questions, just questions.
Wayne, you have significant...
Oh, shit.
All right, so there's an analysis. Is no gender issues. You have no gender issues. You may have subtle personality traits of the opposite sex, but lengthy of transition to my unprofessional but experience. And chances are you agree, and you're probably mostly cool with your biological sex, if not completely cool. You probably... So there is
says,
a little...
My one says you are clearly... A very handsome, young, and eloquent young man who is completely compatible with his own sexuality. If, though, you like dressing up in a wig on a Sunday, that's absolutely fine. And that's what it says.
All right,
and it says, if you want, it's completely not gay to get pegged up the arse by your missus.
Is it not?
That's what it says.
Is that not gay?
It's not gay. Because it's a woman involved.
Okay. That's fair enough. That'll be okay with women. Wayne, what do you think about that test?
Don't bother doing it, people. It make you sign up.
Broke the fourth wall.
We did.
Wayne, did you learn anything about
trying to get that signed up.
We did. Did you learn anything about transgender this week, Wayne?
That taking the quizzes about them sucks. That's what I learned.
Nothing. You okay with transgender women coming into your bathroom?
God, I'm not that bothered. Because like I said, I'm in a cubicle.
But what if you weren't in a cubicle? Are you okay with
that? Oh, I am in a cubicle, so it don't bother me. Oh my God. Right, ifs and buts don't bother me because I do what I do. I am what I am.
Sticks and stones will break my bones, but names will never break.
And he is so much not fun. It's insane how much not fun.
Sometimes, when he's at the slow gin, he's fun. Yes. When he's not at the slow gin, he ain't fun.
He doesn't want to hypothetical anything.
Nothing's
Aunt,
hypothetical.
Aunt, how would
it's
you
all
feel,
serious.
Aunt, how would you feel, Aunt, if you... Or at the urinal with your dick in your hand.
That'd suck me off, wouldn't they? Huh?
A transgender woman
walked
in.
Because that's our talk. Yeah.
It is.
I'd say, actually, fam, I'd say, you've got a nice cock there. Should we tug each other off? What I'd actually say is, would you like it up the arse?
I would feel very uncomfortable watching.
Depends how big the cock is. It's got a tiny cock, it doesn't matter. If their cock, and that is a serious answer.
Are you serious?
If their cock is bigger than yours, you'd worry.
Let's say their cock's bigger than yours.
Then I'd be very uncomfortable.
Just because
you
of the cock.
You do know, Ant, that toilets don't come with, like, you know, the theme park rides. You've got to be of a certain height to go on the ride. They're in a certain, like, ruler that say your penis has got to be of a certain length.
I'm saying if a woman comes in and she's got a bigger cock than me, yeah, I'm pissed off.
I'd be a little mad too, but I wouldn't be
I wouldn't be offended by it. I'd just be, no, I'd do the British thing. I'd be like, oh my fucking.
How do you like these lemons?
Do the British.
Yeah, in my head, and then just walk off. All still right. Pissing my pants.
I don't have any problem with it. I think they should be able to go with whatever. I don't think any transgender.
I didn't say they couldn't do that.
Yeah, yeah, I know you didn't. I know you did. Wayne did, but I know you did.
What?
Wayne
fuck
just
off.
Wayne hates gay people.
I just
as
said
well.
They totally can does. Go in wherever they want because I'm going to be safe in my cubicle. I'm happy in my cubicle.
So automatically, Wayne, you're automatically Wayne, assuming Wayne, that they're going. Wayne, that Wayne. They're, that they're
we
going...
were just off air, and you just said if you've got a penis and you're a woman and you're black, that's like the worst.
Oh, here we go, trolling.
You hate black
transgender
people. With AIDS.
Well, that's it for this week. Wayne, what do you got to say?
I like getting trolled.
You like it? No fun, Wayne, this week.
No fun, Wayne. I preempted it before the show.
You did, yeah, you did.
That he didn't
that.
Have no slow gin to hand.
And what did you learn this
week? I learned this week that Wayne... might possibly be a transgender, but he certainly wanks on buses.
He's good.
I found out my wife gave a blowjob to a weird man in a pub.
Yes, you did.
Have a great week, everybody. Facebook.com/cerebralsatire. The website is cerebralsatire.com. Email us at cerebralsatire@gmail.com and at Twitter, cerebralsatire. Have a great week. Say goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye, everybody. I will kill you if you move it.